finish off mentioning that hadith, Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he mentions Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, لَيْسَ الشَّدِيدُ بِالسُّرْعَةِ إِنَّمَا الشَّدِيدَ الَّذِي يَمْلِكُ نَفْسَهُ عِنْدَ الْغَضَبِ. This hadith is narrated by both Imam Bukhari and Muslim rahimahumallahu ta'ala in their respective sahihs. What he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned is that a strong person is not that individual who can wrestle and throw people to the ground. Rather, a strong person is that individual that can control himself, who can control himself, keep himself under control when he's angry. I mean, on this subject, I mean, because some of the brothers, they were asking about the Conor McGregor, Khabib, and so on. Listen, this much I will say. MashaAllah, the brother done fantastic job. He's a great fighter, he's a great champion. And what I really like about this brother more than anything else is the fact that the brother is humble. He's humble. I mean, when you see Conor trying to taunt him with the whiskey, trying to put it in front of his face and saying, drink this, and he was literally using foul language in the man's presence, but he didn't lose his cool. لَيْسَ الشَّدِيدُ بِسُرْعَةِ إِنَّمَا الشَّدِيدُ الَّذِي يَمْلِكُ نَفْسَهُ عِنْدَ الْغَضَبِ. He can control his anger. He can control his anger. It's not all about just throwing people to the ground. He didn't react to that particular time. And we see, subhanAllah, even up to the very end into the fight, even when Conor McGregor, the stare down, he smacks his hand down, subhanAllah, he still keeps his cool. Yet at the end, because of words that were exchanged between Dill and Danis, chucking out some garbage at him, he does lose his cool a little bit. Fair enough, let's put that to the side. All credit due to the guy. He's a fantastic champion and I wish him the best, and obviously for the future as well. What I'm concerned is you brothers, is where, for example, someone, it gets overhyped with all the fighting between people and getting overhyped between the hype of the fight. Look, understand one thing, subhanAllah. You know, I was online and I just watched a few clips, and there's Muslims underneath commenting, Allah is great, Allahu Akbar, Islam is the truth, Islam is victorious, and subhanAllah. Okay, just assume this. What if he lost, then what? What, ma'adallah, na'uzubillah, what, Islam isn't great anymore? Is what, Allah's not great anymore? Where are we going with this? Where are we going with this? So tomorrow, remember, he's at his peak now, but in 5 years, 10 years, he may not be on his peak. I mean, okay, let's just say this Mayweather and Khabib fight does go through. Obviously, he's got to get cleared by the Nevada state and so on, which is a big task because he's in their bad books at the moment. It goes through. And then you've got someone who is a pinnacle in his career, right? Okay, which is Khabib, against someone who is known to be a fantastic boxer. We can't doubt the geezer. He's a great fighter as well. What if he loses there? Then what? What, Islam then is no longer great? You know, subhanAllah, it reminds me, and I want to share this with you as well. In the Battle of Uhud, where the Muslims, they suffered heavy losses. They were initially victorious. As you know, there were 1,000 against 3,300 munafiqeen left them, and then the Muslims were only left down to 700. 300 deserted them. Even, subhanAllah, they were right towards the edge of victory, and then because of a misunderstanding, the Muslims then lost. Okay? Ibn Qami'ah, he attacked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the Muslims went through some serious losses. When the munafiqeen, they saw the morale of the Muslims getting low, it was at that time they thought, now is our golden opportunity to start infiltrating the Muslims, start making them doubt their faith, start making them really think about what the faith that they've entered into, because for them it was all a game. For the munafiqeen, it was all a game. It was just something that they showed by face. So to seeing the morale of the Muslims, seeing the morale of the people, seeing the morale of how the Muslims had started losing control on hearing that the Prophet ﷺ was no longer more, they started losing their morale, they started going crazy, some people losing their cool, and subhanAllah, it got really, really out of control. On this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down the following verses, وَمَا مُحَمَّدٌ إِلَّا رَسُولٌ قَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ رُسُلٌ أَفَإِن مَاتَ أَوْ قُتِلًا قَلَبْتُمْ عَلَىٰ أَعْقَابِكُمْ وَمَنْ يَنْقَلِبْ عَلَىٰ أَقِبَيْهِ فَلَنْ يَضُرَّ اللَّهَ شَيْئًا وَسَيَجْزِ اللَّهُ شَاكِرِينَ. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is but a messenger. And indeed, many messengers have passed even before him. Many messengers have passed before him. If he dies, or if he's martyred, what, would you turn back on your heels? What, would you turn back away from Islam? Would you turn back away from the haqq and the truth which you've now entered into? But then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, وَمَن يَنْقَلِبْ, he who turns back on his heels, he never can harm Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the least. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shall reward the graceful ones. What is mentioned by the graceful ones? Ya'ani, those people that hold on firm to the deen in the life of the Prophet and after his demise, Allah will reward these people. When the Sahaba started losing morale, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent these verses. Muslims lost on the battle of Uhud. Muslims lost. Hamza, one of the greatest warriors that this ummah saw, he also was martyred in that particular battle. Sahaba momentarily felt a bit despondent, felt a bit low. Did this make them turn away from their deen? No, they understood that halat and conditions come from Allah. We have ups, we have downs, we have highs, we have lows. We have all predicaments that can come particularly our way, but that should never mean that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forsaken us. Remember one thing, Muslims, they learn from this mistake, and there was khayr in this. What was the khayr, you may ask, in Uhud? What was the benefit of the Uhud when they lost? The benefit was this, was that now they can see who are the munafiqeen and who are the true believers, who are the real believers and who are the fake ones. It's possible tomorrow Khabib loses. It's possible someone else loses. Muhammad Ali lost, Mike Tyson lost. Does that bring any dag and any shame to the name of Islam? And to go a step further, subhanAllah, Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, on the demise of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what happened? Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu was so moved with emotion, that he said, if anybody says that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has died, he is literally gone to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Moses went to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and came back, and he will come back and cut the hands and feet of those people who said that he's died. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu dismounted, entered into the house of Aisha radiallahu anha. He kissed the forehead of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he came out. Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said to Umar, Umar, sit down. Umar radiallahu anhu didn't listen. And then the people turned to Umar radiallahu, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, and they left Umar radiallahu. Abu Bakr said, Amma ba'd, man kana ya'budu Muhammadan fa inna Muhammadan qad mat, wa man kana ya'budu Allah fa inna Allah hayyun la yamut. Remember one thing. It's not about the coming and going of people. It's not about who's victorious in the octagon and who's a failure in the octagon. It's not about who's even victorious in Uhud and who's a loser in Uhud. The ultimate success is the Akhirah. But what did he say? Whoever worshipped Muhammad, then understand that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam has died and left this worldly abode. وَمَنْ كَانَ يَعْبُدُ اللَّهِ. But whoever worships Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, verily understand that Allah is hey, he is forever alive and he never dies. And then he said, قال الله تعالى وما محمد إلا رسول قد خلت من قبله رسل أفإن مات أو قتل انقلبتم على أعقابكم ومن ينقلب على عقبيه فلن يضر الله شيئا وسيجزي الله شاكرين وما كان لنفس أن تموت إلا بإذن الله كتابا مؤجلا ومن يرد ثواب الدنيا نؤته منها ومن يرد ثواب الآخرة نؤته منها وسنجزي شاكرين. Now Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is a messenger, and many messengers have passed before him. If he dies or he's martyred, what would you turn back on your heels? He who turns back on his heels, they can never harm Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the least. Shay'a, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shall reward the grateful ones. Every soul shall die only with the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at an appointed hour. Whoever desires the reward of this world, we shall give him thereof, and whoever desires the reward of the hereafter, we'll grant him thereof. Soon we will reward the thankful ones. Soon we will reward the thankful ones. SubhanAllah, Allah mentioned the same verse about thanking, giving the thankful ones again. My dear brother, it's not about who's victorious. I just get shocked at the mindset of the Muslim. SubhanAllah. Oh, Allahu Akbar, Islam is great. Okay, so what if he flopped? What, so Islam is not great anymore? Man, we need to fix up and get, I know, I understand we get a bit hyped, and good luck to the brother. I like the brother, he seems like a genuine guy, he seems like a good champion, and I make dua Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, keep him safe, keep his family safe. He seems like a good guy. And I make dua for this Conor McGregor guy as well. Allah give him hidayat, man. He just runs his mouth too much. And I think, bichara, sometimes I think that, you know, it's all a money game and it's just about taunting your person just for a bit of attention. But the real victory of Islam is not here, my dear brother. The real victory of Islam is for ourselves, how we will meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of Qiyamah. That's the real victory. That's the real war. That's the real thing we've got to go through. Where we are going through this worldly life as a test, the struggle against shaitan and nafs, that's the real war. And we have to stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of Qiyamah and give an account. I want to finish off on one incident, subhanAllah. Mufti Muzaffar Hussain Kandalvi, rahmatullah alayhi, a person of the past. Anyway, there was this jagara, there was this ikhtilaf, there was this fasad between Muslims and Hindus. There was some ikhtilaf over one specific piece of land. So the Hindus were one side claiming that this belongs to us, and the Muslims were claiming likewise that it belongs to the Muslims. SubhanAllah, the Hindu guys, my God, listen to this. The Hindus, they said, if Mufti Muzaffar Hussain Kandelvi gives testimony that this land belongs to the Muslims, then we will say it belongs to the Muslims, no problem. Then Mufti Muzaffar Hussain Sahib was called, he gave a testimony in front of the judge, and he said, Judge Sahib, the straight issue is, this land does belong to the Hindus, the Muslims, it does not belong to them. Obviously, subhanAllah, the Muslims are saying, you're like this, and patani kya, passing issue and fatwa, and patani, start going on a wild one. listen to what the judge said. But listen, this is what the judge said. Listen carefully. He said, today, verily, the Muslims have lost. Today, verily, the Muslims have lost. But today, Islam has won. Islam has won. Allahu Akbar. Let's be those people. Let's shine with our akhlaq. Let's shine with our kirdar. Let's shine with our good attitude. Let's shine with our nature. Yes, it's alright to be a bit hyped up and so on, but let's not forget that these are all tests. The winning and the failing and the coming and the going. If Muslims lost the Uhud, does that mean, na'uzu billah, they were a failure? Never until the day of Qiyamah. Just remember this before we start losing our cool, and let it not be that we also fall in the same trap.